just all enjoyed the recap of season 1, episode 8, The Knox. I enjoyed doing the recap of it because, like I say, this is where we first introduced to The Knox. And with my trusty illustrated companion here, I am just going to describe a little bit in here what it says about The Knox. And they say, The Knox, a race of diminutive gentlefolk, The Knox are more akin to mystical forest creatures than human beings. Resembling Victorian fairies in appearance, they seem to inhabit a forest world, their attire and skin blending in with the colours and textures that surround them. Although placid and docile most of the time, they have enormous strength of will and can display great determination and resourcefulness when their peaceful philosophies are challenged. Possessing powers far greater than anyone else, well, their own at the time, SG-1, they can appear and disappear at will, can provide a cloak of invisibility to whomever they choose, and can reintroduce a life force into another being by pooling their chi with other members of the Knox community. Along with the Asgard, the Furling and the Tolan, they are the guardians of all that is good and productive in the universe. So that's a little bit about the Knox, so that's something nice to learn about. And obviously you can see straight away that, you know, for like an advanced race, that they do look just very primitive, and they do look like something that, you know, is out of fantasy, you know, like the stories, the fairies and stuff. So yeah, and I think Armin Shimerman was a very great choice to play this part as well, because again here it says colleague Michael Shanks feels there was another aspect to their learning experience. Armin Shimerman was very much the mentor in more ways than one, having been part of the long-running sci-fi franchise Star Trek Deep Space Nine. He had more experience than any of us in working through the various practical challenges this medium throws at you. He understood what we were trying to do in terms of building the mythology, and quietly shared that experience with us. It was wonderful working with him. It wasn't just sweetness and light on the set that week. So that was, it's nice to hear like in from something like the Illustrated Companion of what the other cast members think of that episode. Like when I was saying, oh, since I've been using this one, it's nice to just put into my discussions at the end of it of what a certain cast member thinks about that episode, or the director, because it's just great, I think, just to get that sort of sense of personal touch point. Like I say, I really do like this episode where we're introduced to the Knox. You know, they look primitive, but they are technologically advanced. They are advanced in terms of they can bring people back from the dead. They have superior healing powers. They can put large objects, like their entire floating city, and make them invisible. So yeah, they are advanced, and it's fantastic that we are introduced to them quite early on. And I do like that they obviously then blended it into, when we come to the episode, the fifth race, that the Knox are part of the fifth race. Well, we actually technically learn about them in the Torment at Tantalus from the writings on the wall in that castle, the meeting place. But yeah, I hope all you guys enjoyed this recap of season 1, episode 8, The Knox. Like I say, look out for next Wednesday when I will be doing my merchandise opening. And look out for the rest of this week, which we've got up until Sunday, for the two quiz questions that I am putting on, because I missed the one out last week. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe and like for more videos. And I'll see you on the other side.